Hey everyone, this is Derek here, and in this quick tip video, I'm going to be talking about how to join custom rooms faster in PUBG Mobile. And the inspiration for this video comes from the Solo Chicken Dinner event, which is currently running on PUBG Mobile's official channel. It's running for 2 weeks, and Samsung, in collaboration with PUBG Mobile, is giving away a brand new Samsung Galaxy S9 every night to the winner of the third match played, which is a solo third-person perspective match on Snahok. I'll be hosting again this upcoming Saturday, that is September the 29th, so definitely set a reminder if you want to watch me then. It's going to be at 8 PM Eastern Time, which unfortunately is 5:30 AM for those of you in India, which is definitely not very convenient, but I certainly appreciate your support if you're up anyways. So everybody's always asking, how the heck do the same people join these matches? Because what it seems like happens is we have the same, you know, out of the 100 people in the room, we have the same 50 or 60 names at least every night of the event. Well, that's because they know this tip that I'm going to show you right now. So let's go back to the game, and we're going to go ahead and click on Classic there underneath Start just to bring up this screen, and we'll go to the Custom Room screen. So basically how most people think you have to do it is everybody's putting the room ID and the password in the chat now, which is good because the stream delay is a little different for everyone. So that's a good first step towards making it fairer. However, certain people, like I said, are still getting in faster. So what the normal person does is they wait, they see the room ID and the password show up on chat by the host, and then they go up here and they try to frantically type in the room ID. Let's pretend it's a 54643. Okay, good. Now they have to click enter, enter it, and then obviously, you know, if it was a real room, then you'd have to enter the password like this, and then you'd have to fumble around and enter that thing too, and then click enter room. Now that's pretty slow. I mean, it might seem fast if you don't make any mistakes, but it's still really slow. Basically, how people do it instead is they are looking. So there's a minute delay on the stream. It's actually a little more than that. It's usually about a minute and a half or so. So as the Miramar game is winding down, the second game's always on Miramar, third person perspectives duos. And as that game's winding down, once you're down to about 10, 15 people left, then you want to already get your game booted. So you have to be watching on a second device. You can't be watching on the same device. You'll never switch in time. But you have to have your device booted and in this screen just like this. Obviously, there's going to be no room ID entered when you enter the screen, so it'll look like this more so. And like I said, once you're down to the final circle, say there are only a couple duo teams left alive on Miramar, you want to start hitting refresh and searching for the Snahok room. Because remember, there's a minute and a half delay, so by the time you're watching the ending of Miramar, there's a good chance that the creator is already making the Snahok room. And how do you know it's theirs? Well, it's going to say Snahok, obviously, but it's also going to say created by, and that's where we're looking for whoever is hosting. So for me, it's going to say RKX DerekG. So you're going to see a room that says Snahok, and it's going to be called something. It might be called Solo Chicken Dinner Room, or I might forget about it and it'll just say DerekG's room. But basically it'll say created by DerekG. So you want to start scrolling down here, like I said, as Miramar's winding down. If you don't see the room yet, then it probably wasn't created yet. You hit refresh and you do the same thing again. So let's pretend that Nova Fox here, let's pretend that that's my room. So as soon as you see the room, remember the ID and the password are not going to be in chat at this point. They're not even going to be out there. So once you see the room, you want to click on it. Then you want to go to the room password, click on that. That way, when you see the room password and ID put out in the chat, you don't have to enter the room ID. This saves you a good 3 to 4 to 5 seconds, which makes all the difference. So instead, hopefully this makes sense. Like I said, you're finding the creator's room before they give you the ID. That way, all you have to do is enter the password. And if you want to be even quicker about it, I know some people who are using USB keyboards or Bluetooth keyboards connected to their phone to enter the password faster than using the virtual keyboard here to type it out. Now, obviously, you can't use the keyboard to play the game, but as far as typing in a password, it's perfectly legal and fine to do it that way. So the fastest people who are getting in there consistently, just to recap, they're waiting. So for this event, they're waiting until the Miramar game starts to wind down. When it's down to the final few circles, you know, final 5-6 people alive, they're already in the custom room page. So again, you click on classic here to bring up all these options, then you click on room in the bottom of the screen, and they are scrolling frantically through all the custom rooms. It looks like a lot, but there aren't that many. There's probably only 100, 150 or so at a time. So they're scrolling through these, trying to find the room that's created by whoever's hosting it. So let's say Echo Gaming is hosting tomorrow. Now he isn't, because he's hosting... Actually, it's Wicked tonight, so I don't know, maybe it is Echo tomorrow, I'm not sure. Let's pretend it's Echo. So we're going to be looking for a Snahok room. You can see there are a bunch of wrangles, so we're looking for a Snahok room created by Echo Gaming. Once we find it, pretend that Memorex is that room, then what you want to do is click on it, click on enter room password, and that way when it's shared in the chat, you don't have to mess with the room ID, you just enter the password and you go right into it. And like I said, the fastest people are using keyboards instead of the virtual keyboard to get in even faster. So hopefully this video helped you out. If it did, this is definitely the fastest way to join the room. Now the thing is, as more people watch this video, more people are going to know the method. So it's still going to be hard to get into the room because everybody's going to be joining even faster than they already are. But at least now you have the fairest shot to get into the room and potentially win the game and win that brand new Samsung S9 phone. So again, my name's DerekG. If you found the video helpful, definitely give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing for tons more PUBG Mobile content. I'll be hosting this coming Saturday. That is September the 29th at 8 p.m., 5:30 a.m. IST. And I hope to see you guys there or in my Discord server, which I'll also leave a link to down below.